Hi, we're Ellie and David, and we're overlanding across Europe and Central Asia in our Land Rover Defender Yak. We did it!
Wow! Woo! Unreal.
We're across.
Oh, I've got to go left here. Got to get insurance first. He said we're looking for a glass building. A building with mirrors.
So we've just been to the ticket office, we've got a receipt, we're going to go to the bank and pay and then bring it back and hopefully we'll have our ticket.
I will give you a ticket after I know the name of the ferry.
So we've just paid $50 each for a COVID test, which we didn't think we needed. So that's a bit frustrating, but we're waiting on the results. That should come in a couple of hours. So Ellie's just gonna make some soup for us. And then after that, I think we drive over there, which is the customs point. We wait for the ferry to come in. Could be a couple of days, could be here by tomorrow. We're not really sure, but we go over there and we wait. And that's, I guess, where we'll be living until the ferry comes.
Cabbage soup for dinner and some Home Alone 2.
In Russian.
So it's now 1 a.m. Ellie's asleep next door. There's a room where you can just sleep on some chairs that lie flat. I've just finished doing a job application for when we get back. I think the ferry's leaving at 8 a.m, so I've got an early wake up call, so not going to get a lot of sleep tonight, but hopefully tomorrow we'll be getting on the move. So they've told us that the ferry was leaving this evening and then another ferry came in and blocked the way, so we don't know, we might leave tomorrow morning, we might not, we'll see what happens.
So I ended up getting to bed at about 3 o'clock last night, because it turns out when you're doing a job application that late you make many, many mistakes. And kind of once I'd been through it and finished it all off, I was going to go to bed, and Ellie had kind of pushed two chairs together so that we could kind of sleep next to each other in this waiting room next to where I was doing the application. And I walked in and there was just this random woman sleeping next to Ellie.
I don't know why, but she walked right to the back of the room. There were loads of empty beds, but asked if she could go on the one next to me, which was fine. But yeah, I didn't get a lot of sleep.
No, yeah, so I was just a little bit confused. But I was like, right, okay, so I tried to sleep on the chair, got about maybe an hour and a half sleep. We've woken up, it's now 8:30, no sign of the ferry leaving yet. So maybe we'll try and sleep a little bit more before it leaves, but not really sure. No one really seems to
kind of
know.
They seemed fairly certain that it was going to come in the morning when they were talking to us last night, but now nobody's saying anything else, so yeah. Who knows. But we expected this, it's fine.
Yeah. So we've been getting kind of anxious that the ship there is the one we're supposed to be getting on. We've just been to speak to a guy over at the border control and he said that ours won't come until 3 o'clock, so we'll just kind of wait until then, see what happens. It's 1 o'clock now, so just wait another couple of hours.
Big group of port workers just came over and chatted to us. I think they were just interested in the Land Rover. They didn't speak any English, but we tried to communicate with them a bit. They all wanted photos with us as well, so we've done a bit of a photo shoot and photos around the front of the Land Rover, and they've been putting it on Instagram and stuff, so that was quite funny.
It's now 5:10 and there's no sign of this ferry leaving yet, so I'm guessing ours is still out somewhere just outside the port waiting to come in. Getting very, very bored now. We could, for all we know, be waiting another 2 days, so just trying to be patient. Ellie's having an even more difficult time trying to be patient working with this very old laptop on the next YouTube. We're maybe gonna go and buy some food to cook something tonight and then probably get quite an early night, unless we're leaving tonight, in which case we could be up for a lot longer. So yeah, just kind of taking it hour by hour at the moment.
So I've just been speak to the border guards, because again the ship's not left yet, so we're just wondering what's going on. And they said, we use translator, say the ship will leave and I think ours will come in, because I said to them, oh, I don't know, should I leave the roof tent up, should I take it down? So they said, you rest and we'll come and wake you up when it's time to board. So we're going to sleep kind of after we've eaten. Might be 1 in the morning, might be in a couple of hours, might be able to just get a little nap in, and then we're going to have a rude awakening. Or the ferry just won't come yet and we'll have a nice night's sleep.
We just got chatting with a couple of really friendly Turkish guys. I think they might be truckers. But yeah, they just came over and started chatting to us. We spoke about some of the places we've been to in Turkey and said we loved it there. And they've invited us for tea and coffee, I think, at the cafe that's just over by the containers over there, in about an hour. We're pretty tired, but it'll be good to go and chat with them.
So I think I've just got a bit prematurely excited. A load of trucks started driving towards the customs checkpoint, which is just over there. And I thought, oh, maybe it's time to go, and I was about to start getting the tent down, but most of them have switched their engines off now. We've had no indication that we should come up and start queuing up, so we're just going to wait and see again. It's now 10 o'clock, I think. Yeah, 10 o'clock, so we could be here for a very long time. Remember, two YouTubers we watched, they've said it took about 6 hours to actually load the lorries onto the ferry, so we could be here for a very long time. So I'm not going to rush yet, but just got a little bit excited because I'm getting a bit impatient. But it's a bit silly, really, because we've been waiting in Georgia for about 3 weeks, so I should be able to wait a couple of days for the ferry. So we've now made it right next to the ferry. They're just unloading it, and we'll go on after they finish doing that, so maybe another hour, 2 hours. It took us quite a while to get through. There was a lot to go through, the customs and the border. I went back and forth a few different times because they had real issues with my passport. I don't know if it's because I've got the new one post-Brexit. But then they started talking about the drone as well, but we're all through now. We met some really lovely guys. There was a colonel who spoke kind of semi-good English, and he was able to communicate with us a little bit and helped us out, and he was really friendly. He said we're welcome to Azerbaijan and to stay with him whenever we want, which was really nice. And then when we got here, there was a guy kind of waiting at the ferry. We went to drive onto it, and he said, no, it's full. And we thought, oh my word, are you serious? Have we come all this way, gone through all of this for it to be full and have to wait for the next one? He said, 2 hours ago, we boarded and we really panicked. But what he meant was, in 2 hours' time, we will start boarding once all of the lorries and trucks that are on it currently have got off and kind of cleared the area.
I don't know if you'll be able to see it, but that's our ferry on the left there. So hopefully we'll be on it soon, and we're looking forward to sleeping for a long time. So we've just got given the keys to our room, and it's so nice, I can't believe it. All the things I heard kind of suggested it wouldn't be that good. But yeah, the bathroom's pretty clean. Got a shower. The beds look clean as well. We got given fresh linen when we came in, which is good. We've got nice big wardrobes, which are lockable as well. And our own sofa. and the best bit is we've got a window. Yay! Get to lie down.
So tired. That's like 3-4 hours sleep across like 3 nights. So we were parked just outside where they searched all of our bags, and we asked, you know, when do we go? And he said that they'll come and get us. And we were kind of waiting, and we must have just fallen asleep, sat in our chairs, because all of a sudden, I think Ed, you woke me up. I don't really know what happened. I'm still in a bit of a daze. And Ellie was asleep against her window, and I was kind of asleep with my head on the steering wheel, and the guy was like, you can go in now. So we're going now, and people are shouting at us in Russian and Azeri, and we parked in a tight space between two lorries. We've got all of our stuff on, we've come into the cabin, and it's really nice, and it's just nice to kind of finally be on after kind of days of uncertainty and not knowing when we'll be on or if we'll be on. So yeah, really pleased to be on now and going to sleep now, I think.
I think we've definitely been given like the premium cabin, haven't we?
Yeah, it's really good.
I think that often happens when you have a female with you. We've read online.
Yeah, I've read an article that said if you've got a woman with you, you often get a private cabin with an ensuite. So don't have to share with anyone, which is really nice. And yeah, just going to sleep for the next 18 hours.
We just walked up to the deck and they beckoned us into the bridge so we can look around. It's really interesting to see.
This is our boat, Alert. This is a channel. This is our road. We go here. And next chart is here. Yes, here. After that, it's next chart.
Okay.
This is our kind of paper. This is an electron chart. This is our position, is now. Bow thruster. Stern thruster, bow thruster.
Is the engine Rolls Royce?
Yes, Rolls Royce. And wind is slacker. It's all running on the stuff there.
So when we were chatting to the guys up in the bridge, we found out as well that this is this ship's third voyage. So that explains why everything's so clean, just because it's so new. They also said that we're the first tourists that have been on it, which is really cool. Feel very honoured.
So we were given these forms earlier to fill out and give back, and have no idea what it says. So I think we fill that out now. Someone else is going to come and collect them up and take our passports back again. They've also got the vehicle V5 at the moment, which I'm a little bit nervous about. I know we'll get it all back at the end, but it's just a little bit scary, them having all of these documents. Ellie's decided to take over because I've not used a pen for a while and my handwriting is pretty bad. So we've got about 45 minutes until dinner. Ellie's not been feeling so great the last couple of hours, but feeling a bit better now. He stood outside for a bit. We're going to watch a film. Or at least half of a film until dinner time.
Got some fish and chips for dinner. Good.
How's the fish and chips, Ellie?
Really good. I really like the fish. I don't know what type of fish it is, but it's nice, salty.
So after about 18 or 20 hours, we've made it. We're here. We arrived in Kazakhstan. The crossing was really painless, apart from Ellie being a little bit ill.
Yeah, it was a lot easier than I thought it would be.
Yeah. So hopefully it's just as easy to get off. But yeah, we made it. We're here. It's just unbelievable the amount of paperwork that's had to be done. We've had two taxes. And we think they're legit, like it was all done officially on computers, it wasn't a bribe or anything. Just weren't expected. The first one was...
There was something about disinfecting the Land Rover, which didn't happen.
So we paid $80 for that first one, and then the second one was about $45, I can't remember. And that was for temporary import tax, which we've not heard about before. We can't see anything online, but I think it might be new because everything, again, it was all done through paperwork.
It's all official, it's just frustrating that we didn't know about it, but...
Yeah, and it's just taken so long, so we're gonna...
I think it's been 9.5 hours since the boat docked.
It's just ridiculous. So we're gonna go to the city, now, Aktau, it's about an hour away. And the guy just came out to check our chassis number and everything, and then he said just be careful when you camp in cities because there are walls and stuff like that, but I don't feel like camping in a city, but we'll be safe.
Finally through.
So we're going to change our route slightly. We were going to go through Uzbekistan to pick Ellie's sister up in Kyrgyzstan, but we need a permission for our drone because they're banned in the country. So you can apply for media accreditation, but that takes about 4 weeks for it to be processed. So we're going to change our route, which actually is quicker anyway. So we're going to go through Kazakhstan fully to get to Bishkek. We've got maybe like 8 days of big driving ahead of us, but we're really excited to be going through this landscape.
Yeah, I'm just so excited to be on the road again. It's felt like ages since we've been doing this. And also we get to do the Aral Sea. Our route takes us through that area, which is really cool because I've always wanted to go there. I studied it in school and I've always like been a bit of a nerd about it. So looking forward to that.